I've been testing out the new AI editor tools in Dzine, and it's seriously impressive. You can swap objects, clean up backgrounds, change clothes, fix hands easily without ever touching Photoshop. Today, I'm going to show you how I use these AI editing tools to turn a casual photo into something Instagram friendly. Along the way, we'll explore how each feature solves real creative problems, so you can apply them to your own use case. Let's get started. So in today's example, let's take this casual doom scrolling and a grungy alley photo into something more polished and Instagram friendly. So first we open a new project and just upload the image to the canvas. And today we're using Dzine's full AI editor toolkit. We have local edit, insert object, AI eraser, generative expand, and hand repair. I'll show you how each one helps you turn any photo into image you actually want. First, let's use the AI eraser to clean up the obvious concerns. Let's not let the garbage lying around and maybe the holes on her pants can be removed. We'll see a quick reminder when removing objects. Basically, it says to leave a little space around them so we can make sure we include the full objects and also the shadows. That will give AI better blending results. Then we want to select the parts we don't want. To make a selection, you can use the lasso tool to draw around the area you want to remove, like the ribs on her jeans. We can also use the brush tool to paint over unwanted areas and adjust the brush size for more precision. Use auto and let the AI handle it for you just by clicking the area you want to auto select, and it will guess the part you want to select. And don't forget, we can undo and redo the steps in here. Switch to unselect mode and anything you mark will be subtracted from the selection. We can also use inverse selection to flip it. So instead of selecting the object, we will select everything around the already selected. If things get messy, just click clear all to start fresh. Let's click back to the previous steps. After we select the unwanted objects, hit generate, and the AI will then clean it up and fill in the background and what was supposed to be there. Garbage gone, and the jeans are looking a little more on trend. Double click the image we want to send the result to the canvas, and it will be added to the layer panel so we can work on the new layer. Let's see if we can remove the tattoo on her arm. Let's select the arm area. Hopefully it doesn't erase the whole arm. Okay, good. The arm is still there. It understood exactly what I was trying to remove. Next, let's take a look at the updated insert object feature. It recently got a major update, and now it can swap objects into your image almost perfectly. So right now the graphic tees gives off a more teenager looking vibe. Let's switch it up and give her a more polished Instagram model style. First, we'll select the area we want to change her top. Let's zoom in so we can see better. You want to be as precise as possible and not miss any color pixel of the old clothes. But it's okay to slightly cover onto the skin. Now we'll upload the reference image of the new top. Optionally, we can also describe it. Something like a vest can work here. Sometimes the more details you describe, the better the result will be, but depending on the complexity of the object. Then click generate. I think the vest fits perfectly on her, almost right down to the seams and fabric folds, and even the buttons. It does blend perfectly with the original lighting and pose. We can send the desired result to the canvas to further edit. So now let's try something trickier. Instead of looking like she's always on her phone, we'll swap it for a Starbucks cup. I heard that apparently coffee makes you instantly relatable. Since the cup will likely appear above and below her hands, we'll select those areas to make sure it blends properly. And I recommend to avoid overlapping small details like the shirt buttons if we don't need to change them. We can type Starbucks cup in the prompt. Click generate and let's see what we get. It blends into the scene so perfectly. It does look like she's holding the cup. I am impressed that it kept the wavy shape on the lid. And for this one, even with the hands partially covering the logo, the AI still preserves what the logo should look like behind the hand. I generated a second time for more options, and you can see even the little text underneath is there. It's too small to read, but at least the AI knows it belongs there. We can also use insert object to add logos on clothes, bags, jeans, and I usually blend in naturally. This is actually one of my favorite tools. I actually use it for real projects like adding logos to mockups or making quick branded visuals. Realistic hands used to be one of AI's biggest problems, but not anymore. In our image, after a few adjustments before, her hands start to look a little bit strange and blurry. And this is a perfect time to use Dzine's hand repair tool. We simply have to select the area where her hands should be to let the AI generate more natural detail. So after selection, click generate. And now the hands look sharper and more realistic and properly posed. The tool doesn't just clean things up. It actually creates hands that match the pose and lighting with crisp details and natural structure. Local edit lets us make targeted changes to specific parts of the image. In this case, I think the mirror on the wall could use a little refresh. Let's open up local edit, click auto, and select the wall. And nicely grab most of the area we're targeting. And I'll clean up the edges with the brush tool to get a cleaner selection. Now under here, we can describe what we want to see. And here's my prompt. Pastel mural wall with whimsical shapes in pastel yellow, blue, pink, and purple colors. I will set the style to realistic. And for control method, we can select which source of guidance is more important for the mark area. We can select prompt, balance, and image. I'll choose balance, which gives us a nice blend of the original image structure with our prompt. Click generate. And now the mural feels way more polished and Instagrammable. The building on the right still looks a bit rough, so I edited that with a more pastel color style exterior to match the new vibe. Finally, let's expand the image so it is the Instagram square size using the Generative Expand. There are multiple preset aspect ratio options for us to choose from. And then we can just click to change the aspect ratio, or we can also drag the handles on the edge of the image to expand it manually. I'll go with a square format. Then reposition the subject to center her the way I like. If you want more control over the expanded area, you can also describe what should appear in the empty space. But in most cases, the default generation does a great job in expanding the border. Hit generate and Dzine will fill in the extra space like magic. And that's it. It's now ready for Instagram. Now it's so easy to get exactly what you want with AI Editor. There's no need to mess with layers, masks, or all those Photoshop nonsense. And you still get full control over what you want and where you want it. Let me know which feature is your favorite in the comment. Try yourself using the link below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.